Good morning, students. Good morning to all. So yesterday we have studied about the sole proprietorship. So already we have completed the first unit and we went to the second unit. In the second unit, the first lesson is the forms of business organizations, right? So many types or many forms are there in these business organizations. Okay. So one of the business organization is sole proprietorship, otherwise sole trading business organizations. So yesterday we have studied about the sole trading business organizations and the characteristics of business organization and some of the advantages of sole trading business, right? Have you remember? Okay, today also we will just remind the portions, yesterday's portions, what we have studied on yesterday. So the sole trading business or the sole proprietorship. The sole proprietorship is a form of business organization in which an individual introduces his own capital, uses his own skill and intelligence in the management of its operations. Okay. If a person are using this own capital to conduct their business organizations and use this own skill to undertaking all the decision making and the intelligence in the management of its operations, so that undertaking or that effort or that business organization is considered as a sole trading business. So on the basis of definition, if we want to understand the meaning, so the sole trader is a type of business unit where a person is solely responsible for providing the capital, for bearing the risk of enterprises and for the management of business. So we can say this is the sole trading organizations. Okay, if a single person are taking the full responsibility for providing the capital, for bearing the risk of all enterprises and for the management of business, is called sole trading business, right? So normally how much of the amount is needed to establishing the business organization? The one individual person only have to arrange all the capital and bearing risk of the enterprises. What are the risk will be arranged in these business organizations? Everything will be bearing by a single man. And management of business. Okay, so how to conduct and how to elaborate, how to take the decisions related to all the management of business is by a single person, is considered a sole trading business. And also next we have studied, so the characteristics of sole traders. So one of the characteristics of sole trader is ownership by one man. Ownership by one man mean, so as a single, as the individual persons only will be able to become as a ownership. Okay. So as he is making all the required capital as a single man, so that the single man only will be able or will have the rights to having a ownership. So the individual persons are conducting the business organization. So this is owned by a single, the same persons. Okay, the sole trader contributes the required capital. So he is not only the owner of the business, but also managing all the entire affairs. Okay, so because of that, he also considered the manager and the chairman and what are the posts, what are the authorities are there in this sole trading business. Everything will be considered at the same man. Next, freedom of work and quick decisions. Okay, so the freedom of work, how the freedom of work will be there in this sole trading business mean? So full freedom or the most freedom of work and making the decision rights also have utmost entirely. Since the individual is himself as a owner, he need not consult anybody else. Okay, if you want to take any of the decision related to expand or reducing the market or producing items or something etc. He does not need of consent the other partners or anybody else. He has the full freedom to taking all the decision related to their work. Next, unlimited liability. Unlimited liabilities means so the responsibilities. Okay, how responsibility is held by the single sole trader business or the sole trader mean? So it is the unlimited. Unlimited mean so even if it is not possible, if the sole traders are not able to continue their business activities, and in case of risk is arranged, and if he borrowed more money from the financial organization, he has to take the responsibilities. Here he must give back all the money by the way of selling their own property. Okay, because as he has the own choice of enjoying the own profit, so the same time he only has to take all the responsibilities. Okay, so their responsibility is unlimited. Okay, next, enjoying entire profit. Okay, how much amount is earned from their business organization as a profit, so the entire profit will be enjoyed by the same persons. Okay, so here he has no need to sharing their profit with any third persons. Okay, because he only put the most or almost all the capital, required capital. Okay, so how much amount of profit is coming from their capital, he only will be enjoy. Next, absence of government regulations. Okay, there is no need to getting the consent of the government regulations. Okay, so the sole trader also will not worrying about the norms and conditions of the government regulations. The government regulations will not affect the sole trading business organizations. Okay, suppose if he want to conduct any of the business, he can easily adapt to their home itself and he can conduct it. Okay, so absence of government regulations also one of the benefit to the sole trading organizations and one of the characters. Next, no separate entity. No separate entity mean so this all the rights will come to an end after the death of the sole trader. Okay, so after the death, so automatically so the sole trading business will come to an end. Next, maintenance of secrecy. Okay, so the, what are the secret decisions are undertaken by the sale trader or the sole trader, so it will not be leak out to the other third persons, because he only will taking all the decisions and he only will apply that decision what he has. Okay, so there is no need to maintaining the secrecy, because he only the person to protect their secret matters related to their business organization. Next, advantages of sole trader. So what are the advantages are there in the sole trading business organization mean? First one is easy formations. Okay, to establish the sole trading organizations, there is no need to asking the permission to the government. Okay, there is no need to earning more capital. Okay, suppose if he has some amount of capital in the form of savings only is enough, he can start at any of the organization, maybe the petty shop, Xerox center, or the tea shop, or single hotel, everything, anyway, such as things he can start. Okay, by having the small amount of capital. Okay, so he has no need to worry about the separate place. He can adapt. He can make their home also as a business center. Okay, next, incentives to work hard. So in the sole trading organizations, there is a direct relationship between the effort and the reward. Okay, how effort he is going to take, so on the basis of taking the effort, he will get some of the reward. Okay, so on the basis of hard work, he will get the reward, because he only is the person to taking all the decision, he only is able to enjoying all the profit. Okay, so how effort he is taking to undertaking the business activities, on the basis of taking the hard work, he will get some of the reward. Not only that, the fact that the entire profit can be taken by himself without sharing with anybody else induces him to work ceaselessly. Okay, so whether there is no need to sharing their profit, so he only will get all the incentives, all the earnings profit. Okay, so he not able to cease by any others. Next, credit standing. So, since his private properties are held liable for satisfying business debts, he can get more financial assistance from others. Okay, so whenever he want to borrow the money, whenever he has need of borrowing the money from the financial organization, he can easily get borrow the money from there because he has more assets. Or how much amount of assets is held by that sole trader? So on the basis of their amount of assets, he can easily get, because there is no one to sharing or gathering the consent to selling their assets to that person. Okay, so easily he can get the credit facilities. Next, personal contact with the customer. So in the sole trading person, in the sole trading organization, the sole proprietor only knows each and every customer individually. So on the basis of that, he can supply goods according to their taste and preferences. Okay. So in this wholesale trade, so there is no need, there is no chance to understanding about the taste and preference of the consumer by the wholesaler. Okay. But in this sole trading organization, the sole trader also considered as a retailer. Okay. So one of the benefit of the retailer, see, he can able to understand or knows about all the details and the taste and preference of the customers, what they want, which product they need, and whenever he will get the more need and less need, everything will be understand and knows about the knows by the sole trading organizations. Okay, so he can able to make the personal contact with the customer. So because of that, he can keep all the customers in the air. Customs itself. So because of that, he can be able to cultivate personal relationship with the customers. Okay. Next is small capital. So small capital is also one of the advantages in this sole trading business. Okay, for the purpose of establishing large scale industries, it need more capital and more assets and more properties and the more number of partnership. Okay, but to start any of the small scale or the sole trading organization, a small capital only is enough. So he can easily adapt or he can easily arrange one of the business organization like a petty shop or the tea shop. Next, flexibility. The sole trader can easily adjust himself to the changing the requirement of his business. If the sole trader want to changing the business organizations from one place to another place, otherwise if you want to extend their business organizations, it is very easy. Okay, if you want to reduce the place of the business organization, you can easily reduce. Otherwise, he has to arrange some other places to extend. Okay, so anyway, so the sole trader will be there in the flexibility to changing or transferring their business activities. Okay, so the 6 point: easy formation, incentive to work hard, understanding, personal contact with the customer, small capital and flexibility. Next, today we will study about the disadvantages of sole trader. Okay, even if there is more advantages, some of the disadvantages also there in the sole trading business organizations. So first one is the disadvantage is limited capital. So how the limited capital is disadvantages to the sole trading business organization mean? So since the capital is contributed by one individual, business operation have necessarily to be an limited scale. Okay, as a single person, if he is very crorepadi mean, no problem, he can able to start the industries as their extent level. Okay, as a poor people or some of the middle class people want to start a union of the sole trading organizations, he cannot extend their business organization. Okay, he can start at the business organization with a limited scale or a small scale only. Okay, by having this limited capital, he cannot establish as a large scale business organization. Next, limited managerial skill. Okay. Single person intelligence and experience may not help him beyond a certain stage. Okay. In this partnership organizations, different type of the people which has the who has the different line of skills. Some persons maybe have the managerial skill, some persons will be the work hard, and some of the persons will be the marketing field. So in this different field, so the persons will have some of the skills. But in this soul trading organizations, only he has some of the limited skill or the particular skill. Okay, the particular skills will not helpful to extend their business organizations and to continue their business organizations, because only one persons are there. Even if the persons are having the skill will be used to in a particular line. So not only that, so the since he has to focus on each and every activity, his managerial ability is bound to be limited. Okay, so he only will undertaking all the decision related to the business activities. He only have to take the more effort. He only is the responsible to do all the events. So when it is like that, so the persons cannot able to continue till the end of their life. Next, the limited unlimited liability. So the creditors have the right to recover their dues even from the personal property of the proprietor, in case the business assets are not sufficient to pay their debts, he has to pay them from their own property. Okay, so when they has one of the unlimited liabilities, if it is any losses are arising in this business organization, he has to sell their properties and give back to the business organizations. Okay, but all the business organizations has some of the stage in which the loss will be arise. Okay, so in the sole trading organization, if any one of the time the sole trader must be facing the borrowing money or the risk of losses. Next, lack of specialization. Since the business unit is small and the financial resources are limited, experts in different fields cannot be employed to secure maximum advantages. Okay, so when he has the limited capital, he is not able to arranging the more labor who has the specialized skill in a particular line. Okay, but if a business organization want to improve in their production activity or in their organization as a continuously, so the organization must be has some of the skilled labor who has the specialized skill in a particular line. Okay, but in the sole trading organization, the lack of specializations always one of the characters. Okay, so the sole trader will not able to earning more profit. Next, hasty decision. So the sole proprietor is more likely to take hasty decision as he need not consult anybody else. When the sole trader are very rationalized people or the intelligent people mean, he will take some of the good decision related to their business activity. Okay, otherwise if it is not rational or intelligent, he will take some of the decision which is not affected, not help to improving their business activity. Okay, but when one organization has more labor or more partners, so every partner will have some of the different type of the idea or decision related to their business activity. Okay, but here the only one person who have to take all the decisions. Okay, but this decision may or may not be as a good, or it will be helpful to their business organization. Okay, so always, so in this sole trading business, so the sole trader will take sometime the hasty decisions. Okay, so what are the disadvantages are there in the sole trading business? First one is limited capital, the small capital. Because of that, he cannot able to increase their organization. Next, limited managerial skill. Okay, because of having the limited managerial skill, he will not able to arrange. Next, unlimited liabilities. He must reback the money to the money lenders. Next, lack of specializations. Okay, the single persons does not having any specialized skill in a particular line. Next, hasty decision. Hasty decision means the wrong decision. Okay, sometimes so the individual persons can have the chance to take the hasty decision. Okay, students. So the in second unit, the first chapter is completed. It is the very easiest lesson. So the sole trading business organization only, just to study. And now we will go to the next lesson. So in this lesson, if you have any doubt, please ask me. And now we will go to the next lesson. So in the second unit, the second lesson is Hindu Undivided Family and Partnership Organization. So this is also one of the form of organization in non-corporate enterprises. Okay, we have studied, you know, non-corporate enterprises. So in this non-corporate enterprises, the Hindu Undivided Family and the Partnership Organization also one type of form of organization. Okay, so the Hindu Undivided Family System or Joint Hindu Family System is a distinct form of organization peculiar to India. Okay, this is one of the traditional modern of the business organizations. Okay, but this type of organization only existing in our India. So this type of form is created by the operations of La Hindu Undivided Family Firm, the operations of La. So the Hindu Undivided Family System does not have any separate and distinct legal entity from that of its members. Okay, so normally one of the business organization is undertaken by the whole family member is called as a Hindu Family Organizations or Hindu Undivided Family Systems. Okay, normally in our area also we will see some of the undivided family system, you know. Suppose the undivided family system, they are belonging in these Hindu religions, and if they are conducting any of the business organization, so we can consider it as a Hindu Undivided Family System or the Hindu Undivided Business Organizations. Okay, so the business of joint Hindu family is controlled under the Hindu law. So Hindu law means, so before done up the business law, some of the Hindu law already was there. Okay, on the basis of the Hindu law only, this type of the organizations are undertook. Okay, so the membership in this form of business organization can be acquired only by birth or by marriage to a male person who is already a member of joint Hindu family. Okay, suppose if any of the persons want to become as a membership in this business organization, he can easily begin by the way of birth in this same family. Otherwise, any of the other females are have to get married the male members who was already being as a member of joint Hindu family. Okay, so this is also one of the ancient form of organizations. Okay, so before done up the business law, some of the law was there by the monarchy, under the monarchs. So when two or more families agree to live and work together and invest their resources and labor jointly and share profit or loss together, then this family is known as composite family or Hindu undivided family. Okay, Okay, students, today is enough, I think. So tomorrow we will study as a very first thing. Okay.